again. This is still Stand Up and Bite Me. We're going to bring your next comedian to the stage. She was born in Peterborough, Ontario, now making her home in Vancouver. Please welcome Michelle Shaughnessy.
I'm Michelle Shaughnessy from Vancouver, and I'm going to be Canada's next top model. Sorry, I mean Canada's next stand-up superstar. I've been doing stand-up for approximately 6 years. My mom made me want to become a stand-up comic, actually. I always just wanted to do like acting and stuff, and she forced me to do it when I was a teenager. I did it once, and I fell in love with it. I guess the stuff that inspires me would be, you know, like relationships and life experience. Everybody has like one weird story in their life that's just so out there that people don't believe happened to them. I have about 100 of those stories, and that's what I bring to the stage every night. In my opinion, the greatest stand-up comic of all time is Jason Blanchard, because he's a judge, right? No? Okay, forget about him. Whenever I have a bad show, I immediately go home, turn on the TV, and eat my feelings all night long. I'm gonna win this competition because I want it so bad, and I've just been working so hard, and I'm gonna go out there and rock it tonight. I got a message for all the other competitors in the competition tonight. Watch out, I'm not as nice as I look.
Thank you. As of today, I've officially been single for 72 hours. He was 40, I'm 28, and before you guys get on me for the age difference, I gotta tell you, if you're in your 20s, have sex with somebody in their 40s at least once. Just do it at least once, it's awesome. They're just full of thank yous. So grateful. We had an argument though, I had to let him go. Had to let him go. I broke my foot about 6 months ago, I gained 20 pounds. He pointed it out. He did, he goes, you know, I love you, but you're letting yourself go. Said, I'm sorry, baby, I just wanted us to match. 40-year-old gonna get on a 28-year-old girl about gaining a bit of weight. Come on, I'm like, you're 40 and not rich. I'm 28 and chubby. This is what you can get. I am not gonna take flack from a guy that looks like Paul Giamatti. It's fine though, my little sister tells me this. She goes, Michelle, if you want to get to know the next guy that you date, you got to open your eyes and look deep inside his heart. Open them and look inside his heart. Well, I know that's not true. Pretty sure if you want to get to know a guy you're dating, don't waste your time looking inside his heart. Look inside his computer. The guys aren't laughing because they're fucking worried. Yeah, that's what it is. That woman's intuition stuff we're always talking about, that's us going through your shits. Women have been going through their men's stuff since the dawn of time. It's true. Moses' wife used to peek at his tablets when she wasn't around. It used to be the 9 commandments. She's the one that came up with that. Thou shalt not covet the neighbor's wife. They had a hot neighbor. I just love it because guys can't get away with that. They can't get away with doing that. That's why it's brilliant. If a guy tells his friends, oh, my girlfriend went through all my stuff, they're going to be like, well, because girls are crazy. Girls are all crazy. But if I told my friends, oh my God, my boyfriend went through my emails and all my stuff, they're gonna be like, oh my God, call the police right away. He needs to be arrested. That is creepy, that is not okay. I'm not bitter about anything though. My very best friend in the whole wide world called me today and told me she's getting married. I'm very happy for her. Summer is the time for weddings. She's marrying my other best friend and I actually set them up. I played a good matchmaker, you know? They're one of those annoying couples. Don't become one of those annoying couples. Those couples that forget they have friends when they get into a relationship. I hate that. I set up my two best friends and it's like they forgot I even existed. But live and you learn, right? Like don't set up two friends when you only have two friends. I get all awkward too. Like I don't even know how to be on the dating scene. I turn into like a giant nerd. I don't know how to act. I did a show last night and after the show, this gentleman was like, hey, your glasses, they're really sexy on you. It's like, thanks, I have astigmatism in both of my eyes. Like, I don't know how to play up the naughty librarian thing. I don't know how to do that. I was actually once with a guy that asked me to act like a naughty librarian in the bedroom. I didn't know what to do. I showed up with like the new Harry Potter book. He started to talk dirty. I'm like, shh, Dumbledore's coming. I get so weird. I was made fun of my whole life, though. I ran into some girl I went to high school with yesterday, and it brought back all these terrible memories. I was made fun of so bad. I used to be a lot bigger than I am now. I'm actually probably about 90 pounds less right now than when I was in high school. I know. I was huge. And seeing that girl brought back all those terrible memories. I had the worst mean nickname. If you guys were picked on in high school, you probably had a funny mean nickname. Probably wasn't funny to you, but it was probably funny to everybody else. I didn't get that respect for like a clever mean nickname. I was fat, my name's Michelle. They called me Fat Michelle. Like that wasn't a nickname, that was a description, and I was not happy about it. And I remember one day, I'm minding my own business, eating my lunch, and I look up and I see Fat Michelle written on the wall in the girls' room, because that's where I was eating my lunch. No, don't feel bad for that. It was like 2:30. I had already had my first lunch at noon with the rest of the kids in the lunchroom. So at 2:30, I'm hiding in the bathroom eating my secret lunch. And Fat Michelle is glaring at me on the wall, just glaring at me. And that's when I knew, I'm like, I know that I'm going to go through 4 years with a mean nickname, but it is not going to be Fat Michelle. I grabbed a marker. I got all angry. I scratched it out. I'm like, no more Fat Michelle. It's Michelle-a-phant. Because that's clever, right? People tell me, they're like, you can't hold on to this stuff. You gotta let it go. Get over it. Forgive and forget. Just get over it. Forgive and forget, you know? People don't understand how tough that is. Michelle-a-phants never forgets. Anyway, you guys have been a lot of fun. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Michelle Shaughnessy!
It was fine.
That's it?
I did the jokes that I knew I was going to do, but I got here and I noticed the audience was liking more of the dirtier stuff, more of that kind of stuff, but that's really not what I wanted to do. So I didn't change my set, and I don't know how I feel about that yet, because I think I would have gotten a bit better had I done some edgier stuff, but what can you do? What went over the best, or what do I think what the strongest material was? Because what I think is the strongest material was the stuff about my weight and about being picked on, because that's real and that's who I am. What went over the best was a cheesy sex joke I did. So that's kind of how I'm gonna sum up my nights and the nights. Again, whatever. Well, no matter what happens, at least my hair looked good. So good night.